At the end of the video I made comparing the Sonoff Mini and the Shelly One, I asked the question, what did I miss? And I got a few answers. These were the things that everybody said I missed. So in this video, we're going to dig into those. Ready? Let's go. One of the most important things that I failed to mention in the previous video was that the relay in the Shelly is not connected to the power input. All it is a dry contact between the I and the O. So if you wanted to use this for a low voltage switching scenario, like we do with the garage door opener, you could do that. But with the Sonoff Mini, the line in is what gets switched at the relay. So you can't use this with like a garage door or some low voltage LEDs. This takes 120 or 240 in and switches that same circuit at the relay. That means only the Shelly can be used in those situations where you want to switch a circuit that's different than the power that's coming into the device. Point to Shelly, moving on. So here's the Shelly connected to power. Okay, it's live. I'll be very careful. Now we measure between neutral and switch contact. Ooh. Okay, just make sure you're aware that that switch contact carries 120 volts. Measuring the voltage at the switch contactors gives me nothing when it's off. But when it's on, I get 3 volts. Another point that I failed to cover in the last video was how these two devices perform in different three-way switch configurations. I filmed a much longer explanation of this, and I'm going to put it out in a separate video, but to be brief, if your wiring looks like this, where the power comes in to the light box and then goes out to the switches, or if your wiring looks like this, where the power comes in and the wires to the lights go out of one of the switch boxes, then either the Shelly One or the Sonoff Mini will work fine. Again, I'll go through details of how you wire those up in a different video. However, if your wiring looks like this, then there is a way that you can use the Shelly One, and Rob from the hookup explained how to do that in a video a long time ago. There's the link. The Shelly One works in this situation because of its ability to isolate the relay. Since the Sonoff Mini can't do that, it doesn't work in this situation in the way that Rob describes. If your wiring looks like this, I don't really know what to tell you. Good luck. So there you go. There's one scenario that the Shelly will work in that the Sonoff won't. So that's another point for Shelly. Next, I also looked at resting power consumption. I took each of these devices, connected them to a Sonoff S31 for power monitoring, and let them idle for 8 hours. As you can imagine, the power consumption fluctuates quite a bit, even at rest. So I took the average over those 8 hours and 1,000 data points. And the results? Almost identical. On average, the Shelly used 0.11 amps and the Sonoff Mini 0.12 amps. Doesn't seem like a big enough difference to matter to me, but now you know. Moving on. Okay, here's my load test setup. Shelly first. I got an S31 here because I want to measure the current, and then I got a 1500 watt heater. Let's see what happens. The Sonoff S31 is reading 14.26 amps right now. We'll see how this sucker holds up. It's been 1 hour. The laser says, look like 47. Infrared camera says 49.6. All right, be back in an hour. It's been 2 hours now. 49, 50, maybe 51.4. Back in an hour. Oh, there's a 51. 54 on this. Well, we're gonna keep going. Okay, back again. Not getting anything more than 49. We may have hit the peak, 50. I'm gonna check back one more time in 1 hour, and if it's not any hotter, then maybe we'll call this one done. Okay, I forgot to set the timer, so it's been quite a while. It's quite a bit cooler outside, 43 is all I see. Kinda went through a hot spell in the afternoon and has cooled off a little bit, so 48, 48, 49, that's it. I think the Shelly held up pretty well, so time to now swap it out for the Sonoff Mini. According to the instructions, this has a 10 amp maximum. I already know that this is a 14 amp load. So I am definitely risking damaging my Sonoff Mini, which has me a little sad. I will miss you, Sonoff Mini, if you perish. But since we're doing a comparison, and it seems like the right thing to do, to use the same load, so that's what we're gonna do. Here goes.
All right, my Sonoff Mini has only been cooking for about a half an hour, but I'm just terribly curious. 23, 31, 33, 34. That's better than I thought it would be. 35 on this. Wow, it hasn't heated up terribly. I kind of thought it would start to melt fairly soon. Check back later. It's probably been an hour and a half. It's a little unfair because the sun's up, so I think it's going to be extra hot. 52, 54. And the hottest pot, 57. Little unfair with the sun on it, because this wall itself is hot. We're gonna stop until this gets in the shade. It's afternoon. It's been an hour plus. 49.7. That is a lot less than it was at 9 o'clock this morning when the sun was beating on it. So that was an unfair test. So this is gonna be much better. See you in an hour. Well, it seems we've had an event. It turned off. It's not terribly hot. That didn't take long. It's been about 2 hours, I think, since I turned it on. If nothing else, we did discover that you should not use a 14 amp load on the Sonoff Mini. Probably kind of knew that. All right, time for the autopsy, I guess.
Kind of knew this was possible. Got this guy connected up here now. Nothing. So it's dead. I killed it. Well, don't load it beyond 10 amps. I only have one more of these. I could use a smaller load, but I don't know that that would really be a fair heat test. I don't see anything visibly wrong. There's no burnt components that I can really see, but it's sure dead. So a moment of silence for our fallen comrade. Okay, what's next? Wi-Fi signal check.
I've got my Shelly connected to a really, really long extension cord. So I'm gonna walk out there and see how far I can go before I lose connection. Might not be the best test, but it's a test. So here we go. Okay, still good here. Still good here. Wow, still good here. That's as far as I can go to test it. Still works. Now we'll do the same thing with the Sonoff Mini. Same test now, but using the Sonoff Mini. Gonna take a hike, be right back. Plenty responsive there. No problem there. No problem there. It's the end of the cord. No problem there. No delay, nothing. I don't think we're proving anything with this test. This already has a Sonoff Basic in it. For some reason, this box is the worst Wi-Fi signal of any of my devices. I think it has to do with a vent. There's a tin air conditioning air return vent here in the wall next to it. So that, I think, has something to do with it, even though there's a router access point here 15 feet away. So it should get a good signal, but I lose this device all the time. I'm thinking this is probably the worst spot for a device to potentially connect to my network. So this is where I'm gonna test the Shelly and the Sonoff Mini. I'll put them both in here and then I'll use Tasmota to see how the connection is. All right, so in here, this was actually a three-way switch. So this is a three-way wire that isn't being used anymore. We're gonna stuff that back in there. Here's our grounds, which we don't need. We're gonna stuff those back in there. This is neutrals. This is the hot, and this is to the lights. So that's our output. Shelly goes first. So let's start making some connections. All right, this will be the output. I am gonna need some wires to go from this to the line and the input. And then I've got a switch here as well. This is also gonna serve as how, we'll see how well this actually fits in there. Okay, one black coming out of the line. And one for the in on the relay. And we're gonna tie those two together with the hot. Okay, we've got a neutral wire. Neutral there. These switches don't do too well with skinny little wires. All right, we're going to put this to the switch, and we're going to put this to the hot. That's everything. I'm going to briefly turn on the circuit breaker and see if it works before I stuff it back in there. All right, circuit breaker's back on, and we've got functionality there and here. Perfect. Let's check out under information, 88%. That's our Wi-Fi strength. Stick it in the box. Two purposes there. One, we'll see if that decreases. Two, we'll see how well it fits in the box. So back to turn the circuit breaker off, since those two guys right there would shock poor Dr. Z's. Pretty good. Fits pretty well, plenty of room. One more test and then we switch it out for the Sonoff. Toggles on and off just fine. All right, let's just double check that Wi-Fi connection again. Okay, we're down to 82%, which as I recall was about what that Sonoff Basic was giving me as well, was 82%. Sonoff Mini's turn. Okay, we've got neutral in. This is line in. And this is out. And then I need one more neutral. And now we just need these two switch legs. Double check everything. Neutral, 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 neutral. Line in, going up there with the three-way wires, which is getting power from across the room, great. And then line out, going up that way. And then the two switch connectors. Okay, that's it. Let's turn on the breaker, check it out. Okay, and then we go to information, and look at that. The signal strength is 74%. And this has this antenna. Okay, well, we'll stick it in the box. We'll try and expose the antenna, and then we'll see what happens to our 74%. And I'm putting this antenna way out here. We'll see if that does any good. Try and give it the best chance possible. They both fit just fine in the box. Honestly, the Sonoff is a little bigger, but the Shelly requires more wires, so I think it's a wash either way. I think having extra wires makes it a little bit harder for the Shelly to fit in, even though it's smaller, and then the Sonoff, not having the wires, kind of makes up for being a little bigger. I didn't have a problem fitting either one of them in. Probably the easiest of all the things I've ever tried to stuff in a switch box. Okay, that's all working fine. And we're at 78%. So still lower, even with this thing hanging out here, still lower than the lowest that the Shelly got. How about that? Wi-Fi strength, Shelly wins. And then as far as how they both fit just fine. So.
Well, that's it. Part two of the Shelly One versus Sonoff Mini comparison. We looked at the different voltages on their switch connections. We put them in different three-way switch configurations. Looked at the resting power consumption, put them under a load and did temperature testing, and in the process killed my Sonoff Mini, fit them in a switch box, and tested the Wi-Fi strength. That's pretty thorough. And through it all, Shelly came out on top again. Still doesn't mean there's not a place for the Sonoff. In fact, I am going to leave that other Sonoff Mini in that switch box where I was testing the Wi-Fi connections because I want to connect a temperature and humidity sensor in that spot because I need one in that area of the house. If you want to see other comparisons, let me know. That's all for now. As always, thanks for watching. Till next time, adios. If you need help or want to chat with me or others who also enjoy projects like this, you can find us on Facebook and Discord. If you like what I'm doing and you want to support me, you can use my special product links in the video description. Or head over to Patreon or just like and share my videos. That's easy. If you like this video and you want to see more like it, this box will take you to a playlist of some of my favorites. In addition to videos like this, I also do live streams every Sunday. This box will take you to a recording of the latest live stream. That's all for now. Adios.